So it is Saturday and we are at the Lexington Cemetery again, and you can see somebody was buried here probably not that long ago because they have the concrete like Mom had on hers. But as we were driving over to Mom's grave, Kevin spotted this one, and we don't remember seeing it before. It's really, really pretty. And I don't even know if Kevin could tell from the road that this is the shape of Kentucky down here and the horses, and I love that. And then right over here in this area, the it's like just this circle of benches, of concrete benches, and it looks like they have in memory of names, and there's trees, very shaded. That's really, really nice. I like this area. So anyway, I'm gonna get a picture of this because I have a lot of pictures of unique headstones, and this is the most unique one I've seen in a long, long time. That's just really that's really pretty. Okay, we are I would say gonna feed the ducks, but clearly we're gonna feed the geese.
They're all coming over.
Yeah, they're coming over. They know what's in the bag. Come on, little boy. I had some stale bread at home and some buns that we use for Ashley's birthday cookout. And so I actually remembered to bring it with us today. And I bought a couple packages of crackers too. They're not stale, but they will be like in the second week of July, so I thought, well, I'll go ahead. Kevin likes to make friends. You have to gain their trust. Kevin usually gains the trust of at least one before we leave. Yeah, he likes to make friends. Yeah, Kevin would be good on a farm. He would make friends with all the chickens and a couple years ago, my sister lived in a place. It was on a lake, and they had all kinds of ducks, and they didn't they have didn't they have like two swans?
Yes.
They had like two swans, and so we would go out there and take crackers and to her neighborhood, and we would feed the ducks, and it was so nice. It was a really nice neighborhood.
The swans were mean. Huh?
Yeah, the swans were mean. You would think the swans would be nice, but
here they come. They know my voice. This is ridiculous. I think that's our small.
Hey, boy. Do they come up on land?
They'll come right up here.
Oh,
they come up between my legs.
Joy.
You can watch them get up on me and stuff?
If they'll get up on your lap, yeah.
Oh, gonna name you Lucifer.
It's amazing how many there are. I mean, they're way over there. They're over here. I mean, if they wanted to come and just eat your face, they could. Because there's so many. There's a baby? I think it's ugly because it doesn't have hair. Honey, I don't have anything. He took it all. He took all the food. I just have a camera. There's lots of poop. Yes, there's no shortage of poop. He's like, Gavin, get it out of your pocket. I'm trying to see the baby, but I can't avoid the poop. I see it. Look. Now listen, people. I don't have anything just because I'm walking over here. I'm just here for the shop.
You missed it. Number two.
They're coming up behind you, Kevin. Oh, there's the baby. There's the baby right there, the one that has the fuzzy hair.
I like the crackers because you can flick them.
You can, but they're behind you, Kev. Oh, did you give them both packages of crackers? Okay, now here's the bread. Now come.
Baby went. I can't hand them this. I don't think it's
anything. Sure you can. Do it behind you. Look. Look. Yeah. Once they see that it's bread, they'll probably come towards you. Now I'll try to get one towards you. Oh, he got scared. Are you all seeing this? They're getting fed and you're not. You're just standing there.
That one's very gentle.
Oh.
See how gentle it is?
Don't think my leg's a turkey leg. Oh, did they eat all the bread? At least it didn't go to waste. They act like they're really hungry. Yeah, because sometimes so many people come out here that they don't even look at the food because so many people have fed them.
I don't think they like the crackers.
They probably don't because they're flat. Yeah, I'd say they like the soft bread better. I'm going to try to get this goldfish on camera. Kevin spotted it as we were driving by. This is the other lake, and it is just a gigantic goldfish. And there's lots of turtles over in this pond. Hopefully you can see them. They're all floating in the water. I swear I see like 10. That's crazy. So this is the pond that we should have go to for turtles. And the other one is the one we should go to if we want to feed the geese. That's amazing how many turtles there are. And I'm sure you can't see them. But it's a gorgeous day. Okay, last week I showed you the flower garden and we're here again. And honestly, the summer flowers aren't near as impressive as the spring flowers, like the tulips and all that. I mean, it's still pretty, but, and I know they haven't grown up fully, but they don't have the color, put it that way. They don't have the pop of color. So, but they do have a magnolia tree here, and they have it trimmed up. And you can see this is a good day to be out here because absolutely no one is here. No one is here at all. But this magnolia tree, it's interesting because this magnolia tree has actually been trimmed up. When we were down in at Disney in Orlando, they had a lot of magnolia trees, and I noticed immediately that they weren't all grown. They didn't have like branches coming out at the bottom, and they weren't dragging the ground. They were all trimmed up, and I thought, wow, I didn't know you could do that to a magnolia tree. Of course you can if you take care of them. So this one, they have trimmed it up, and I think it still is much, much higher than the ones in Orlando. The ones in Orlando, they've topped them off, and they really are the perfect height. But at least this one isn't dragging the ground, and it does look really pretty. So anyway, there's really just not that much to see, but I promised you that I would get back out again in a week's time, and so I wanted to come back out here. See, these will grow up. All of these flowers will get bigger, and so there will be some color here. You'll see a lot more color in this area. I guess it's just early on. And this tree's really pretty. I don't know what kind of tree this is. That's nice. So there are flowers here. I just haven't given them a good opportunity to grow some. You know, this is July. This is June. Maybe I need to wait until July before I come back. So we might just do that. Okay, we stopped at Culver's, and we have french fries, and we both got, Kevin got a double burger, and I got a single, and that's it. We're just going to sit here and eat in the car. Okay, we're going in Bath & Body Works. The semi-annual sale's going on. So I did spend some money in Bath & Body Works, but not much. I really didn't buy anything that was on, that you would consider really on sale. But that'll be in a haul that'll come up. Now we're going in Target. We're not going to be in here very long though, because I have stuff in the car that I'm afraid will melt. So after Culver's, we went in Meijer, and I don't think I showed any of that at all. And then after Meijer, we went in Bath & Body Works. I had received a coupon just this morning that if you spent $25, you could save 20%. So my goal was to just spend the $25 so that I could save 20%. And it turned out that I found a candle that I really, really, really like the scent of. And if you watch my hauls, you'll probably see that haul before you see this. But I'm definitely keeping one of those candles for myself. But then after Bath & Body Works, we went in Target. And I know I just got quick snippets, but it's just because we were only in Bath & Body and Target for a very short period of time because we bought some stuff at Meijer that I was afraid would melt or not be the same if we left it in the car too long, because it is 90 degrees outside. And two of the things we bought were bars. We bought, I Instagrammed a picture, and I think I tweeted it and put it on Facebook even. There's two new Jif peanut butter bars, and I know if we left those out in the heat, those are not going to be the same. So we went in Bath & Body quickly, went in Target quickly, and now we're on our way home. And even now in my lap, I have one bag in my lap from Target just because I didn't even want to put these in the trunk. These are new Ghirardelli squares. They are milk and sea salt brownie. and they had a coupon on there for $1 off. But I did not trust those to the trunk at all for even a minute. So I have that bag, the Target bag, up here with me. So anyway, we're on our way home, and what we'll do is we'll go in and we'll haul what we have so far, and then we'll go back out and we'll probably go to Kroger first. Usually we go to Kroger first and then Walmart after. I don't know why, that's just the way I like to do it, and Kevin doesn't care which order we go where. So anyway, I will catch back up with you in a little bit. And don't talk so much, you're just ruining everything. So we got home from Target and put everything away, and then, well, we hauled it and did a haul. And then we went to Kroger and came back home and hauled that stuff. And then we went to Walmart and came back home and hauled that stuff. And then we have to put prices on things. And if somebody recommends something, we have to write that down on it. And so anyway, it's just a process. And now we're back home, and I'm outside, as you can tell, because Kevin is mowing the grass. He just finished doing that, and it's actually, it feels really nice out here. And so right now he's weed eating, which I'm shocked because he was saying that his weed eater wasn't working. So I don't know how he got it to work, but I'm glad he did. You can cut those down as much as you want. You can't tell it now because he mowed the grass, but I had pulled out all the weeds out of the middle part from like up to here. And you can tell where I stopped doing it. And because they were under this grill, but he mowed, so he'll have to, he'll have to go down through there and get the grass off. We have some little flowers. I didn't plant those flowers. They come back every year. My mom may have planted them. I don't know. Make sure Kevin closed the gate so that... Okay, there's Pluto. Gate closed. I've been trying to come out here every day, and if I see any little like weeds coming up, I've been trying to pull them up, and it hasn't been a problem yet, so that's good. But yeah, I need to, we bought that grass killer. If you watch my hauls, we bought some grass killer, so the hope is to spray it in here, and it won't come back up, so hopefully that's how it works. He's a freak, isn't he?
Freak in the window. Look at him in those geeky tennis shoes.
Bless his heart. He's wearing his old tennis shoes.
He probably smells awful.
He's so funny. Lord forbid the neighbors look out their window. I wanted to tell you all, this is one of the candles that I bought at Bath & Body. And I don't buy them for the containers, although I wanted to show this is the lid. And I just think it's a really pretty lid. And then this is a label, and I don't know how long they've been doing this, but it's not one of their plastic labels. It like, you can feel it, and it's like a textured label. But anyway, this smells wonderful. The reason I bought two of these. I bought two of these because this smells just like if you've ever been to the Venetian Hotel in Las Vegas. And I know not many of you probably have because it's weird that we've been, but we have. But we stayed at the Venetian in Las Vegas, and they gave us some shampoo and conditioner, and the lotion is what I'm remembering the most is the lotion. They left in our hotel room. This smells exactly like that lotion. And the reason I remember it so well is because we went like in 2012. But the reason I remember it so well is because I kept that lotion for a long time and I just ran out of it because I only use it now and again. So anyway, if you want to know what the Venetian in Las Vegas smells like, it smells like sundress. This is Bath & Body Works candle.
It smells absolutely wonderful. It smells, Kevin thinks it smells like clean laundry, but clean laundry with, there's just something else in it. There's a strong, another strong scent in there, and it is just fantastic.
So, it's Sunday afternoon, and last you saw, Kevin was weed eating, and he did spray grass killer around here. He didn't blow off that sidewalk, though. I thought he would blow off the sidewalk with the lawnmower, but he didn't. But the reason I came out here is because out of the kitchen window, I spotted these orange flowers, and I've been waiting for them to come out. They're so pretty. And I did not plant these. My mom planted these. So it's nice that they still come up every year.
Oh wow, that guy must have just come by. That's pretty cool, isn't it?
And there's Guido. I think Guido's feeling a little better. He seems to be breathing better. I know I said in the last vlog that he wasn't feeling good. And I'm not saying he's feeling perfect or anything, but I do think he's feeling better. So, we bought him these new treats, and they were in our last grocery shopping haul. So, I want to show them to you. Well, let's see. Here they are. They're called Stacker's Chips. And they're by Pedigree. How much were they?
This is a big bag, though. There's 1.5 pounds, and they were at Walmart for $10.54.
But they'll last a while. Yeah, these are cheddar, bacon cheddar.
Look.
Oh, that's what they look like.
Look at it. Look.
Oh, are you gonna dance? Oh, look, poor thing. Well, he seemed to like them.
Yeah, they're soft too.
Let's see. They're not hard. Oh yeah, they're little round saucers.
And they're thin. I don't have any more.
They are thin. Oh, we have one more. One more. Yeah.
And they,
what?
They just have a resealable bag at all.
Yeah, well, we like the resealable bag because usually
we have to get Ziplocs. Yeah. And we might end up with a Ziploc anyway. But.
Yeah, we might do that anyway. As long as they're resealing, okay, we'll use that. But he still has to finish these first. Yeah. I just wanted to show you those staggers. These are those hamburger things we bought a while back. And even though they've lasted a long while. We tear them in half and give them to him. But even though we put snacks in a Ziploc bag like this, they still end up getting hard after a while, don't they?
They do.
No, you can't have those.
We just said, yay!
And I gave one of these. Gavin was here the other day, and I gave Gavin one of these to give to Guido, and I walked away, and I came back, and it was gone. And Gavin was asking for another one.
I think he ate it, really.
He ate it. Yes, he ate it.
I guess it's just me. So.
Today is Monday, and we are going to take Guido to the vet. We think that he's doing fine. His breathing, yeah, you can tell he's perfectly fine. His breathing has been much, much, much better. He's been sleeping fine. But we just want to make sure that nothing is still going on with him and that he doesn't need any medicine or anything like that. So we are off to the vet right now. So this is where we go. It's called Boonesboro Animal Clinic. And they are very, very busy today. So we'll see how this goes. Okay, they were extremely busy in there today. You can turn on the air, Kevin. I'll talk over it. They were very, very busy in there today, busier than I've ever seen them. But anyway, he listened to Guido's chest. He said that Guido sounded very clear. He looked at his ears and said that his ears looked good. He took his temperature. That was completely normal. So he said that it was probably, allergies last week?
And Zyrtec or Benadryl.
Right. We can give him Zyrtec or Benadryl, but not both at the same time. But either one of those will help him because we've done steroid shot in the past, and it's just not good for Guido. It makes him eat more, and he just he has, it seems like he makes him have to pee a lot.
He does, and he can't breathe anymore.
Yeah, so anyway, he's fine. I thought you all would really like to know that, because I know he was, the last time I showed him in the last vlog, he just acted like he was ready to roll over and kill over, you know? So it's nice to know that he's okay. There he is. But it was $35, but it was well worth the $35 just to have the peace of mind to know that he's okay. And he has been sleeping better at night the past few nights since I showed him in that vlog as well. He's been sleeping a lot more soundly. So anyway, might check back in later. So we have been home for a couple of hours. We watched the season finale of Game of Thrones, and not going to give anything away, but it was good. There were some surprises, and so right now we're on our way to Anna and Christina's house. I haven't seen the young master in a couple of days, and I'm sure he'll be excited to see his papa, so I will get him on camera. But also, we are taking over 3 bags of food. It's just various things that we've tried, and some of it we might not have liked so much, which you would know that from the reviews, and some of it we actually liked, but not enough to just keep and eat all the time. And a lot of the things we try, I don't know if anybody notices this like we do, a lot of the things that we try are bars, and like granola bars and stuff, and you can only eat so many bars before you're barred out. So we kept a lot at home, and I will show you that when we get back home, if I remember. Someone asked me to show them like what we have in our cabinets and refrigerator and stuff like that after we've been to the store. We just went to the store this weekend. I think I'll get a lot of comments about the lack of fruits and vegetables, but that's okay. I don't care, whatever. I'll show you anyway, just because I don't lie to you. I always tell you what we have. And so anyway, we're taking over 3 bags. Some of the stuff that we're taking too is some ice cream. Like Kevin did a review of the, and I don't even know if this is coming out yet, the Edie's mint chocolate chip ice cream. And he thought it was okay, but he didn't want to go through a whole tub of it. And he found some other ice cream that he absolutely loves, that he's working on. So anyway, we're just taking over simple things like that, and we're going to see a visit with Anna, Christina, and Gavin for just a few minutes. We're not going to stay because Christina is actually cooking dinner. And so I've got a couple magazines that I got in the mail that I'm not going to look at, and she can have those. And so anyway, I'll check back in with you in a minute.
Hi! Hi! How are you?
You ready?
Here we go. Hi! How are you? Christina's wearing a sweatshirt. What are you doing? He's saying on and going in the bathroom.
We were watching a movie.
You can go watch your movie. You can go watch your movie. We won't bother you.
This is frozen.
Hey.
What are you doing?
Did you miss Papa, Gavin? Gavin, did you miss Papa? Look at the smile. You look so happy.
He feels good.
He's a good boy. He's getting so big.
He is.
Gavin, can you give these to them? Thank you.
Did you already put a stamp on those?
Get it in the mail, you know?
No, wow. Things we brought back from Disney. And what is that, Gavin?
A bear.
A bear. Did you use glitter? Huh?
He put all of the glue on. And now the one that has the shirt that's glitter, I did that. But everything else he did.
Do you like the bear?
Bear.
Bear, yeah. Yeah.
Hair.
Where did you do the glitter? In the kitchen?
Uh-huh. Huh? No, we have a giant calendar. Yeah. We did it over the calendar, and then I just kind of poured it into the trash can. It was really easy.
Well, I didn't know if you did it outside or...
No, I couldn't keep him still long enough to do it outside.
Yuck!
Gavin! Yuck. He said yuck. Did you eat that glitter?
Yuck.
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 Okay. You.
So Kevin and I bought this net for Gavin's stuffed animals because we bought him so many stuffed animals that Christina said they were taking up too much room in his toy box. Look, Gavin just shut her out. Did you shut the door all on me? I like how you have his shoes on the back of the door.
Yeah, he has more shoes than anybody.
That's
else.
Cool. I love the red.
Shoot,
the red Chuck Taylors.
He's
I love
almost grown into those.
Love
where
those.
Are, he loves these.
Those are so cute, Gavin.
You want to put them on?
You want to wear your shoes?
No, we're not going, but you can put them on.
Oh.
Go.
So we bought this on Amazon. I think it was like, I don't know, it might have been $10 or something. And we got it with Prime, so we didn't have to pay anything for shipping. But that works out perfect. So now you don't have to worry about all the toys in the toy box. So this is Christina's tomato plant. It's been a while since I've shown it. It's probably been over a month. But this is her first ever little tomato. So I'm going to document it. And hopefully no dogs come up and eat it or anything. Okay, we're back from Andrew and Christina's, and we didn't stay for very long at all because she was cooking dinner, and when we left, dinner was just coming out of the oven. But someone had asked me to show, like, what foods we have in our cabinet. So I will show you, I'll just show you around. Okay, so this is like, you can see Guido's dog bowls. This is underneath the microwave, and this is where we keep our Cokes. And then up here are, this is where I keep things that I still need to review. So we just went to the store, and I found these Hirsch chips that we hadn't tried before. And I need to show all these things, the banana split Twinkies, and there's a whole basket full of stuff here that we need to try. And so that's like stuff that we don't even look at unless we're going to do a review. And then in the kitchen, I did not clean this at all. So if it's dirty, it's dirty. We keep our drinks on the top shelf. And then on the middle shelf, there's water. And someone wants me to try Pepsi Max versus Coke Zero. And then Ashley has some noodles in a bowl. And there's eggs, and then in here my Laughing Cow cheese and more cheese, and then there's a green pepper and lettuce, and there's onion, purple onion in that bowl, and tomato. And then in the bottom drawer there are sausages and pepperoni, and that is a huge tub of bacon grease. Yep, we keep bacon grease. And then we have butter and all kinds of barbecue sauces and chocolate sauces, milk, and then just the regular condiments. And then in the freezer, we have ice cream, which I should move that down to another shelf so it's at eye level. And then we just bought these at the store for Ashley. I'm sure you've seen these in reviews. And I do need to move some stuff around a little bit. But Kevin just loaded up with meals for his lunchtime review channel. So, and anytime somebody reviews something, I try my very, very best to put a name on it. So, so that when Kevin gets it out for his lunchtime review, he'll know who recommended it. So I try to keep track of all that. And then we just have some potatoes here. We don't refrigerate our potatoes. Bread and buns, and there's some bananas. And then in this cabinet we keep all the peanut butter, my peanut butter, so I'm in this cabinet daily. Chocolate milk, Ashley still loves these Weight Watchers salted caramel brownie bliss bars. She is into the s'mores right now. I have no idea why there's an empty bag up here. I guess She'll use it for something. And then the pumpkin, we had bought way back at Thanksgiving. Kevin was supposed to make a pumpkin cheesecake because, I mean, I absolutely love it. For some reason, I don't remember what reason, he ended up not making it. I don't remember why. But it doesn't expire until March of 2017, so we'll have it this year. And then my crackers, you can see I work my way through them. And then over here, Kevin, there's some nutty bars, one nutty bar left here from a review. And then in here, Kevin keeps his peanut bars. And we also just reviewed these Jif bars, so he put those in here too. And then up here is all my coffee stuff, creamer and coffee and sweetener. And then in here, I have the remainder of Ritz crackers, which I'll probably use those tonight. And then I'll go back to the spoons. And then we have some of these. And Ashley has some Fruit Loops. We bought these, hers, baby back ribs, but we bought them because they were so good. Grace and Allison, I think from Michigan, sent us those to review, and they were awesome. So we bought them again. Kevin does have more chips up here he's working through. He eats these at night for a snack. And just some different chips. And then down here, I just reviewed the s'mores and Cheez-Its. These cookies were really good. These are the cookies and cream fudge stripes. And they weren't in a resealable package, so we have to put them in this. And then these were really good, the 501 cheesecake. And then Ashley had me buy these for her, but she hasn't eaten them in a couple days. So she doesn't eat them, though I will. And then some popcorn. And then in here, I don't get in here too much just because it's baking stuff. There's macaroni noodles, rotini noodles, and then there's spices and stuff like that that mainly Ashley gets in here, or Kevin when they make something. I'm not the baker in the family. And then this is the last drawer. This is the junk drawer. This is our junk food drawer. And so we still have, if you remember, way back after Easter, I did a Target. It was like a Target haul, and it was Easter candy. We still have 6 bags left, and there's a lot of Rolos in here, but there's 6 bags left of those, and so we eat on those a little bit every night, so they won't last forever. And then Ashley buys these giant Hershey bars because she makes herself s'mores, and so those are hers. And then Kevin likes to buy these for meetings. He bought a bag of Reason, that's the only one he has left, and then he likes these to suck on too. So that is it. So you've seen everything, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Mainly the bad, but that's okay. Like I said, I'm honest, and you know, you see what we eat when we do reviews. We eat most of that stuff, or we give it away to Andrew and Christina. Like I said, we gave Andrew and Christina 3 bags full of stuff, and 1 bag was just frozen stuff. So, but you know, all that food we try has to go somewhere, but we're eating most of it. So anyway, I'm going to wrap this vlog up for now. It is 10 minutes till 6, so it's almost dinner time, and I'm going to get me something to eat, probably a peanut butter sandwich and something else to go along with that. Usually it's something that other people wouldn't consider that healthy. Did he say Ash?
Yeah, he was saying Ash, Ash.
This is what he did when we dropped him off at church the other day. Aww. I carried him the whole way like this.
Look at you, curly-headed Ash, boy.
Give me kisses. Gavin's got stuff to show you guys.
You like grab the sides of my face.
Gavin, how old are you?
Two.
Oh, good boy! Oh, wow!
Three.
That is awesome! I'm so proud of you!
You're so small.
You got it on camera.
Yeah.
Yay!
Been working hard?
Yeah.
Gavin wants to show you his part. He will try to get in the pool.
Kevin's missing out. Oh my goodness.
Oh wow.
That's Gavin's car.
Oh my goodness. So Ashley got a new car and Gavin got a new car.
$40 Facebook special came with the mattress.
Really?
Yeah, so now we have a crib and a mattress.
They brought it strapped to the top of their car, just like our car.
Only $40.
It's funny. I actually knew the girl that was selling it. She used to be a patient of ours.
Really?
Yeah, look, there's your...
I know. Yes, I saw it. I had to leave a comment on... they wanted me to rate it, saying how good it was. And I said it fits a lot of stuffed animals.
You like that?
Now, do you think he's going to sleep in there tonight?
He's excited about it.
Ooh.
You see the little footprints? He kicks the wall. That's what he does.
Yeah. What are you doing, Gavin? What? And you can wake up maybe brother or sister next door to you.
That won't stay in here. It's just we're leaving it in here until we see how
I think he'll be like Emilia and Eduardo. They'll wake each other up.
So will the new one be going in that room or be in here?
Probably in that room because the new one's going to be every 2 hour feeding.
No.
Well, actually, no, I lied. No. The trunk will be moved and then that will go in our room. So that's how we do.
Yeah, that was in their room.
Yeah.
How old are you?
That's so good.
We worked on that all day today.
Yay, big boy.
Look, Gavin.
You need to put your money in.
Look. Ready? How would you do it?
One. Count.
One.
Two. Three.
Yay!
Yay!
Can Gavin come up, Christina? Yay! Can Gavin say it? Can you say it? Can you say one, two, three? Say one, two, three.
One.
Yay!
You
want to do it again?
Okay.
Again.
Okay.
Okay. Do one, two, three.
You don't mind giving him change. I give him all.
One, two.
It goes right now.
Three.
Yay!
His savings is bigger than ours.
Oh, yes. That's okay. You can have all my change. I don't need it.
What? One. We only go to five and then we start over.
One. Two. Three.
Two.
Can Gavin say it?
Sorry.
Three. Four.
Oh, good job!
Oh, wow.
Get
emotional. Oh, wow. It's full. He got
it.
He tripped.
All gone.
He tripped.
Yeah, yeah. Well, okay, so he was turning around like this. And I said, take your shirt off. And he did. And he said, belly, belly.
He wants you to eat him again.
Turned him around. He said, belly. And I think he must have said face or something like that.
Belly.
Belly.
But nobody told me.
Betty.
I know what you gotta do. Betty. She apparently did.
Betty.
Well, I knew today. Betty. You just came home. And, yeah.
Betty.
You're our little thing.
So you saw Gavin's car, and here's Ashley's new car, in case you didn't watch the video. It is a GMC Terrain. It's a 2011, and we went for our first ride in it.
Yeah,